doesn't even look like a dragon's eye. It doesn't even look like one. So why did they call it a dragon's eye? I wanted to know much more than this. You know, the path of the dragon doesn't have any rules. Doesn't have. You create your own rules. It's your unique path that you will take when you follow the dragon. But Draconic Wicca in itself, Draconic Wicca when you use witchcraft, then there can be certain rules, because in the ancient times they have discovered certain things, like using the dragon's eye. And using the dragon's eye has certain rules. You know, when I first used this, I didn't know this at all. But you know what I had? I had a lot of love for the dragon, a lot of desire. I even used this simply because it has the name dragon on it, a dragon's eye. And it's used in ancient times. So I said, I wanted to use this. I want to know where this is using, where this is serving for. I wanted to know everything. So I already did a blood sacrifice for my dragon. So I did something, you know, a lot of books said a lot about the dragon's eye, that this was actually an ancient symbol. But in fact, it didn't have any instructions, because it said it was lost in time of its entire meaning. A lot of witches still use this to this day, and that is the reason why it survived. But it really, to know what its purpose was, it was actually something that a lot of people just contradict each other with. So they didn't really know where the dragon's eye was serving for, why it was there, why it exists, the purpose of the dragon's eye. Well, that is in fact with every single symbol. Every single symbol that can be used in manipulation, so in magic, can be very much draconic. From the pentagram to the heptagram, every symbol can be and become draconic. Even the cross can become draconic, as becoming the draconic trinity. But in fact, the true trinity of the dragon will be the dragon's eye. The reason why they call this was actually something that I discovered for myself. I couldn't read from this. I tried, I looked for it, but I didn't read anything of what I actually discovered. And in fact, the dragon's eye was a connection between you and your dragons. And that is the reason why I always call it a dragon's eye and not a dragon circle. Because here, this part of the dragon's eye is where we are, the physical realm. And where they are, that is where the fifth gate is. The fifth gate that is still connecting you with your dragons. And that was actually very revealing. But in fact, in the beginning, I didn't really notice this. Of course, I was experimenting with blood on a knife. And so I stabbed it in the middle of it. And that is where I came to find out, when you stab it in the middle of it, then with stabbing the earth in itself, which is nature, then I feel a lot of energy coming from the ground, that you are opening a gate. You might even say that this, the dragon's eye, is being used in ancient times to summon up dragons, and that a lot of people actually forgot the rule of the dragon's eye that was established once I pinched it, once I stabbed it inside, in the middle of it, with the blood of myself, you know? The dragon's eye. The first rule of the dragon's eye that I discovered is, do not abuse it. A lot of people like to use it, and that is the reason why it survived, and I'm thankful for it. But it survived because a lot of people, witches also, try to summon spirits from it, summon it, and there is a lot of energy, a lot of power inside of it, so they continue to use it. But there is something that they should know: if you abuse the dragon, if you want it for desire and power just for yourself, then it won't work, or it will backfire. This has a high security on it. That is the reason why it's being called the dragon's eye. It has a high security. Once you try to abuse it, once you want to open a very sacred gate like the fifth gate, with just your desire for yourself, for your own selfish reasons, then this might backfire and will open a gate inside of Leviathan's void and not in the fifth gate. So that if the reason why this is happening, because you don't have the feelings for the dragon. You don't have connection with the dragon. And if you don't have this and you are still using this simply out of your selfishness, then this will open a gate to Leviathan's void, aka hell. And that is a place where Leviathan is, of course, but people call it a hellish place, the place between spaces, and that will open. This might as well be summoning the spirit from the Leviathan's void if you are not careful enough. So the first rule of the dragon's eye is do not abuse it. Once you use it, have a lot of desire for the dragon. Know your dragon's energy, connect with them, connect what this is standing for, and do not open Leviathan's void, but do open the dragon's gate with this. This is a way to summon the dragon, yes, but do it in a good way. And the second rule of this, do it alone, and do not invite other people with it, because this is a search engine. This is a way to search your dragons, and when there are other people with it, then it's going to be confusing for this energy that you are creating, because this is solely meant for you. Once you are creating a dragon's eye, you are creating a search engine where your dragons should be found. This is manipulation at its strongest. That is why I say Draconic Wicca, or in itself, and what it used to be. I mean, the Draconic Witchcraft has rules. It has rules. And when these rules are not respected, then things can happen that is very wrong. Just like opening Leviathan's void. But also, do it alone, because it's confusing for the energy that you want to create. Then maybe other dragons will come with it, or as well can open the Leviathan's void as well, if there are people who are not trying to use it for its true intentions, to summon and to awaken the dragon and to open up the gate for the dragon. Yes, this is a way to summon the dragons, but it's not really summoning, it's just opening the gates for them. They did a lot of manipulation to open the gate to you, but you can do the same. And this is your tool. And do it alone. Do it where the symbol is trying to find out your life force. That is why I recommend that on the knife that you are stabbing inside of it, put a little bit of blood on it, or in other cases, you can put on something else on it, as long as it's coming from you, and so that it can search down for your dragons and open up the gates as true draconic manipulation. Do it alone and do not abuse it. Those are two very much rules that I came to understand of the dragon's eye. People like to abuse a lot of things, you know. They like to have advantages over everything. And that is what the old witches of the old, or people who want to use magic, came to find out as well. To abuse the power of this symbol. But they didn't know that it has a security on it. And the security will go off immediately and open a wrong gate, a gate to Leviathan's void, not reaching for the fifth one. Yeah, that is also why it's better doing this alone. Yeah, that is also what I came to understand. Why did they call it a dragon's eye? Simple, because it connects you with your dragons. So here we are, and so there your dragons are. And you are connecting with each other. And so there you come together and you watch through the same eyes. You watch through theirs, and they are watching through our eyes. They are still here with us. So through our eyes, just look into the mirror and use this image. Use the dragon's eye if it's not working, you know. This is pure manipulation. This is pure draconic Wicca, witchcraft, how you want to call it. This is manipulation that I did out of desire. The third rule that I want to say, the rule of the dragon's eye, is when you use it, use your desire. What I just said, desire. If you are not using your desire, if you are not doing anything, then this third rule will eventually do the same, like if you don't honor the first two rules. It can be that it's going to be empty. If you do not have emotions for the dragon. If you do not do this out of pure desire for your dragon, if you're not directing your energy to the dragon, then it might do nothing. It might do nothing. It's just empty, or it will have some energy again to open up the wrong gates. So be careful with the dragon's eye. This is not a toy, not at all. It's a very ancient sign where they just simply forgot what it's used to, where it's purpose from. But if you experiment with this, I was actually lucky that I was always have this great desire for my dragon, and it was always directed to my dragon, and I had the correct emotions for my dragons. And that is why it simply was directing and aiming to Leviathan's Void, but to the fifth gate, immediately to open up the fifth gate. But I don't use it all the time, simply because it can have opening wrong gates, and I don't want that. But as long as your desire for the dragon is true, do everything sincere on your dragon's path. If you do Draconic Wicca, if you do Draconic Witchcraft, if you want to manipulate the gates, then do it out of desire and love, and do it just sincere, everything that you do. That is where it stands for. Three rules of the dragon's eye that I found very interesting, you know, that I came to find out once I used this. Can someone back this up? I don't believe so. I never had this. I was searching down for information for the dragon's eye, but I never had information like this. If you are on the dragon's path, of course. Can it be used for other things, like not using this for searching down the dragon? I don't know, and I don't care. Because I just want my dragon. And that is, I use this because it had the name, the dragon's eye. But later on, I was led to my instincts how to use it. Put blood in the center of it and just wait. You can go inside of the circle as well. But it's not a circle, it's a triangle. But you can go inside of it and feel the energy that comes out of the ground. Feel the energy that comes there, where your blood is in. Your blood is now one with the earth. And so now it can search down for your dragons. Do not abuse this. Do not do this alone. And do it simply with the greatest desire for the dragon.